This is Dr. Lam from drlam.com and Adrenal Fatigue Center. Today we're talking about how nightmares and vivid dreams and whether they can cause an increase in cortisol or norepinephrine. This whole topic actually falls into what we call excitatory and inhibitory neurotransmitter regulations. Now, let us take a step back. The neurotransmitters in the body regulates our brain function. They can be excitatory, such as dopamine, norepinephrine, as well as certain types of amines. Inhibitory neurotransmitters include compounds such as GABA, for example. And as the name implies, one excites you and one calms you down. The body's self-regulation process requires that they balance each other. When one is overwhelming versus the other, then you have a predominance of overexcitation, which will lead to a state of anxiety, panic attack, feeling wired. On the other hand, if you have excitation predominant, then you can lead to a sense of fatigue, sleepiness, as well as even depression. So when you have vivid dreams, first of all, we have to understand is what causes these vivid dreams. It can be cortisol driven, it can be due to too much norepinephrine or dopamine, or it could be due to the lack of GABA, for example. So we do know that vivid dreams and nightmare is excitatory. And therefore, when every time you think of having nightmares, you have to think along the way that, well, why is the body's overall, not just individualized focus, the overall neurotransmitter balance is excitatory. And there are many reasons to this, from metabolic problems to cortisol problems. For example, if your body is in a metabolic dysfunction, such as if you have low blood sugar, then that low blood sugar can trigger norepinephrine release. This can happen in the middle of the night and while you're sleeping. And while the amount of triggering is not enough to wake you up, because the blood sugar is not low enough, it does and have the capability to excite you enough to have nightmares. Similarly, when your cortisol level is low during the night, you tend to sleep well. However, if you have a cortisol spike in the middle of the night, then the cortisol spike can cause a reactive sympathetic response and cause the body to be excited. Now, remember, cortisol is necessary to be high for you to wake up and feel good. And that's why cortisol level tend to be highest in the very early parts of the morning in order for you to get up. It is by design low in the middle of the night so for you to sleep quietly and nicely. If you have a cortisol curve or the cortisol output in the middle of the night that is extraordinary, meaning it is not low but instead high, then you will have a problem and you can have vivid dreams. There are also other reasons as well, but in the case of adrenal fatigue, these are two of the most common. And once you're able to resolve and figure out which one is the main reason, then the solution can become quite clear. Now, the problem is that there's no real good laboratory test to really understand which pathway it may be, whether it is a cortisol issue, a metabolic issue, or neurotransmitter issues at the end. So it really comes down to a very detailed history, because the body's biological rhythm over a 24-hour period is actually quite well regulated. The body has many levels of regulation that it puts in place in order to ensure that you sleep when it's time to sleep and you wake up and perform your work when you're supposed to. When the biological rhythm is disrupted for many reasons, and they could be metabolic, as we mentioned earlier, it could be toxic environment, it could be stressful emotions, it could be many neurotransmitters that are not doing well, either at the gut level or the brain level, because remember, many of our neurotransmitters are made in the gut. So if you have intestinal dysbiosis, for example, you can actually have dysregulated neurotransmitters. So the neurotransmitter balancing really represents a very, very intricate web that you have to look not only at the brain function, but the gut function, the liver function, inflammatory function, immunity function, in order to really come up with a good idea of what is really going on. And this is best done by detailed history, because laboratory tests are not very good. But the good news is once you have a good history and have a handle on the problem, then modulating a better sleep and more rebalancing of proper neurotransmitter function can be easily achieved. I hope you've enjoyed this video. For more information on this topic, head over to drlam.com, where I've written over 1,000 articles to help educate people. You can also call me at 626-571-1234 for more information on adrenal fatigue and how to navigate it. Finally, if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.